And still on malaria, 10 youth leaders have been selected from Ghana to participate in a global movement to advocate for malaria interventions and healthier generations. The participants are expected to lobby policymakers, governments, and global leaders to mobilize domestic resources. Ghana's quest to eradicate malaria has been obstructed due to dwindling donor funds, leaving the population at risk. Global funding reduced by 32% since Ghana attained a lower middle income status almost 10 years ago. As part of donor requirements now, government is expected to mobilize domestic resources to co-finance donor-funded activities and interventions. Malaria is said to account for about 30% of all outpatient department cases. Yet, the National Malaria Control Program hopes to reduce morbidity and mortality rates due to malaria by 75%. It also hopes to provide a prompt and effective treatment to all cases diagnosed by 2020, while protecting at least 80% of the population from malaria and stepping up on monitoring and awareness, among others. The selected participants are expected to, among other things, advocate for malaria interventions.
Their advocacy activities will not only be in Africa. There are high-level activities for malaria intervention and conferences, and we are preparing them also to advocate presidents, and we are also targeting them to participate in the Commonwealth, where policymakers and governments gather.
The National Malaria Control Program hopes to attain a zero malaria status. Hence, its program's manager, Dr. Kezia Malm, is appealing for more domestic resources.
If you look at the countries who've eliminated malaria, none of them have been able to do that depending solely on donors. So as part of our strategies, we are pushing for higher domestic resources. That's through the Ghana Malaria Foundation, through getting the District Assembly Common Fund to be used for the 0.5%, which is meant for malaria control, to be used for it.
Representing a rural community in the capital, the Queen Mother of the Adibiawe subdivision in Ada says she would advocate for behavioral change among her subjects.
I don't want to see people sick. It makes me very sad, and I've been wondering what I can do to help. So once I see this and I know there are opportunities for you to learn and then to know more about the disease.
The youth leaders, who are by default a part of the global movement for malaria and healthier generations, are expected to collaborate with their counterparts from Sierra Leone and Tanzania, among others on the continent, to embark on health promotional activities.